Okay, so we're on Samach Aleph, 61 in Avodah Zarah. Yesterday we were talking about the case of a rolling barrel, and the pagan rolling the barrel, Hasim Kozim Lunei Menei. So the case where it was declared kosher is where it was rolling on its own. Let's go weiter. We have a new Mishnah. Amatar Yenu Shalakum. Nois Nebrishusai. Veis HaPesua. Bavayas HaPesua. Nebrishus HaRabim. Ir Sheyesh Ba'akum. Yisraelim. Buta. If someone is making wine that belongs pagan, the owner is not Jewish, but he wants to get into the kosher wine business. So he's not going to touch it. He's going to hire Jews to make the wine kosher for him. Renting out the vintage floor. If he leaves the wine, we're talking about non-mevushel wine, it's not covered yet. He leaves it in the Gentiles' domain. If the door is open, and there are both Jews and Gentiles who live in the area, the wine is kosher because the Gentile will be afraid to touch it because he knows he's going to lose his business. Ir shekulei akum aser ad sheyeshev mishamer. But if it's a town where there are no Jews, only Gentiles living there, then you need a Jew to sit and guard the wine. Ad sheyoshev shomer, ein hashomer tzorich liyos yoshev mishamer. Some say that you need to hire someone to guard the wine, but he doesn't necessarily need to sit there and guard it all the time. Just he needs to be able to have access at any time. Ein hashomer tzorich Yos Yoshev Mashama Aval P Shiyotsev and Nichnas Mutter. So the Shomer doesn't need to actually be sitting there. The mashgiach doesn't have to be sitting there all the time. Be'ir shekula akum aser sheyoshev mishamer. However, wait, Yosef Nichlas Mutter. All right, that's what we're up to. Rabbi Shimon ben Elazar, I remember Shimon Elazar says, "Rishus akum achasi." Domain of Gentiles is all one. And Matarian and Shalakum, nice night, Shusai, and the place of Lais, Gabaltim, and Kabois, Winter. So if the whole story we had before, we're trying to make kosher wine in the non Jews' domain, and the Gentile writes him a document saying that it's as if I received money from you already. It's all paid up. It's wrote up a receipt. Mutter, so then the wine is kosher. if the right, so it is, so then it's kosher. Avol im yirtzi Yisrael ha'itzi is yain ve'ena menicha ena menicha ad sheitin loy moisav zehai maisa b'meisha'an b'hosra. However, we mentioned this Mishnah in the previous Gemara yesterday, that if the Jew wants to take out the wine and the Gentile says, I won't need to take the wine until you pay me, so then the wine is not kosher, because the Gentile has no fear to touch the wine, because he believes it's his. So the Gemara says, Ir shekulakum nami. Why should a city that's 100% Gentile be not kosher? But Ika Reichlin, Machzirin, Bayaris, there are Jewish merchants who travel around in all these little towns and do business there. So what should be the issue? Amar Shmuel. So Shmuel said, "Beir sheyeshlo delaseis riyach." He said, "Well, what about a walled city that you can't just walk in without without going through?" You know, I remember I was in Panama in the city Colón, where they have a tax-free zone, and in the tax-free zone in Colón, you can't just walk in, you have to go through, you have to, I think, pay a toll to get in. You have to, you know, if you're not doing business there, like we were going there to collect charity, and there was a Jewish, you know, a lot of Jewish merchants there in this tax-free zone. There was nobody lived there in this whole area. It was only a business zone, and tax-free zone. It's the biggest tax-free zone, I think, in the Western Hemisphere. And so a lot of Syrian Jews do business there. So, but in order to get in there, you have to go through. There's a guard there. So something like this: Amar Rav Yosef Achalain Kishus Rabbim Dami. So he said, even if the Jew can't walk in, if there's a window and he can see through the window, then it's already enough that it could be considered public domain. That for this law to say that the wine is kosher, that people can watch. Ashba Krishus a rabbit domain. Also a window that's right next to the door. I thought Ashba is like a trash heap, but that seems to, it's talking about type of window. Even like a peephole to see it, I guess, is enough. Dikva, which is Rabbi Dami. If there's a tree, a palm tree, to climb up and look inside over the wall, that makes it enough, even if no one's actually going to do it. The fact that it could be done makes it sufficient that the Jew could look in. But seek reishe pligaba. But if the head of the palm tree was cut off, some people argue, there's an argument as to the law of Acha Ravina. It's an argument between Rav Acha and Ravina. Chad Asar v'chad Shari. One says it's not kosher, and one says it is. Mandasa Lamale the Salah Kosa. The one who prohibits would say, well, why would anybody go up there? Meaning, if there's no fruit on top of the tree, meaning the reason why the tree would permit it is that you're going to climb up the tree to get the fruit. Once you're climbing up to get the fruit, you're also going to see if able to see over. So there'd be no reason to climb up there, and so it wouldn't be so any purpose of the Manishari Zimna, the Avdali Bahing. The opinion that says it's kosher says, well, maybe the Jew lost a cow there, and he's trying to climb up to see where the cow was selling. Climb up Biyuni Basra to try to see, you know, get a bigger picture of and see where the cow ran. Tana Rabbanan, the rabbis taught in the Braisa, Echad Lekech Vechad Seicher, whether one's buying or selling, Beisa, Beis Bechatsa Shalaku, building a house. He's renting, he's buying, he's selling. A house of a pagan, a low yayin, he's filling up with wine. He's thrilled by Rois Achatzer. There's a Jew who lives in the same courtyard, he lives in the same neighborhood, in the same block. In winter, I mean, you know, the Chetzeris, the courtyards would be all connected, so then it's kosher. Apopisha Ein. Even though there's no key to the house, and there's no stamp on the barrel of wine in the Jew's hand. Should we continue? There's enough. We did one amud. I think one amud right now is good. Chatzar Cheres Mutter, and another Chatzar, it's kosher. All right, I think this is where we're going to end now, because I don't think we're going to be able to finish the whole daf. So it's best at least just to do one amud and make a separate video. So thank you for watching. God bless. Please like, share, and subscribe. God bless. All the best. Thank you.